It's a night of communion, and I wanted to read a quick scripture, Matthew 26, 29. You can be on your feet for 5 seconds while we read the scripture. Matthew 26, 29. When you get that scripture, let's just bow our heads for prayer. Almighty God, the giver of everything good, we thank you, O Lord, for this day. Father, you have heard the prayers of even Brother Anthony and Brother Gessner, thanking you for the life of Sister Joy, my earthly mother, whom have taken her portion now, Lord Jesus. You've granted her to be at your feet at this hour. She's shaking hands with Brother Branham, saying, God bless you, Sister Joy. I remember how you testify and dance to the Lord, and I thank God you received that message. Oh, Lord Jesus, you can now even see Peter and Paul. He has nothing that differentiates her from them at this time, because she has obtained treasure in heaven according to your promise. Lord, how grateful are we that she was part of us in this earth, part of us in celebration of your life, part of us in worship, part of us in dedication. May you, Lord Jesus, help us in our life to continue pressing on, continue the race, my Lord, and run this race with mastery like those that want to win. Lord Jesus, I also pray for my siblings back home, that you encourage them as well, that you give them a heart to have encouragement, not to weep like those that have no hope. Precious Lord, everything is in your hand. Our planning to travel is in your hand. Lord Jesus, whatsoever we need to travel is in your hand. You will make our way, my Lord, to go and put the body down to the grave. Like Jacob said when he passed away, he said, take my bones back to Israel. And Joseph told his siblings, when I die, take my bones with you when you travel. My Lord, my God, is the final right you can give to this flesh. May it please you, my Lord, to help us, Lord, when that time comes, to lead us safely there. Precious Lord, thank you for this life. Thank you for everyone. Father, I know sickness have come among us too. Some people have feverish and cold and coughing and the weather changing. The children, my Lord, even some of my children, my wife, and Lord Jesus, may you bring healing down to each one. May you rescue each and every one of them. May your blood and healing all diseases come upon them. May your grace be sufficient for us. Most precious Lord, we are grateful because you are our God. We are grateful for the message of the hour. We are grateful for this hope that we have. If we don't have this hope, my Lord, then what shall we do? When we are tried, when we are tested, that because of this hope, we can stand the test of time. Oh, I give you all the glory. I honor your holiness tonight. Come, my Lord, my God, and bless our gathering as we prepare ourselves, even for our communion. May it please you, my Lord, to bless the communion. May it please you, my Lord, to bless this meeting. We ask with thanksgiving, most precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But I say unto you, I will not drink henceforth of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. May have your seats. Hallelujah. This was the final word of the Lord addressing us, letting us know there is a meeting that's beyond the sky, that though you might not see it with your eyes, but that meeting is foreordained. The Lord knows on the day of this feast that after he has supped with the disciples, after he had drank with them, he told them, I will not drink of this vine coming from this tree, because there's yet a better vine, hallelujah, that flows from Emmanuel's vein. And that vine is the love of God, and that the Spirit of God himself, Zoe. And the prophet preached that message, eternal life. And how can you get eternal life? The eternal life is Zoe. The life of Zoe, God himself. Hallelujah. And Jesus is telling the disciples, there is eternal life. And on that eternal life, I will celebrate that life with you. Not this life that you have. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Not this flesh that you have. Hallelujah. He's dying every day. Signs are showing us. Friends are showing us. Loved ones are showing us. There's nothing in this flesh that we should perfect ourselves. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But the Lord Jesus has given us an example that we must follow. When he was speaking this way to the disciples, they couldn't understand what he was saying. And he told them, even tonight, he said, many of you will decide to run away from me. You will all be ashamed of me. Hallelujah. It was in that context that Peter said unto him, Master, if everyone will leave you, I will not leave you. I will be with you. And Jesus said, Peter, you are going to deny me before the cup will grow 3 times. Hallelujah. Yeah. Jesus, knowing that Peter has not received that spirit of the truth. Hallelujah. Yeah. When you receive that spirit of truth, it will grind your feet upon a solid rock. Hallelujah. Yeah. When the prophet preached that message, just be still and see the salvation of God. Hallelujah. Be still and see the salvation of God. It was the same word that Moses delivered to the people of Israel when they got to the Red Sea. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When they got to the Red Sea, they were looking at a different life. The life they see, the physical thing they see, the water they're looking at, the obstacle before them. Pharaoh's army coming behind them. All the hills around them. There were no way out. Hallelujah. And Brother William Marabon, I'm saying, the time that he got the most success in his ministry is when he can go nowhere, when he can go no more, when there seems to be no way out. Hallelujah. In other words, when you're constrained, when you can't do it with your own power, with your own strength. Hallelujah. It is then that you will let go and say, Lord, I can do nothing without you. Lord, may you take over from here. Hallelujah. If you have come to that point in your life, my friends, that is the time that God can show you that he is your maker. After all, the battle is not your battle in the first place. The battle is the Lord's. Hallelujah. The battle belongs to him. Hallelujah. The battle of life is his to fight. You just believe the word. You just keep pressing on. You just get, Lord, I am here. I can do nothing without you. Hallelujah. Even the vine you told me, Lord. You said one day you'll drink from this vine no more. There's a better vine waiting somewhere beyond the curtain of time. Hallelujah. When there'll be no more tomorrow, there'll be no more sadness. Hallelujah. There'll be no more sickness. Oh my God. Hallelujah. Are you looking forward to that day? You know, sometimes when that day comes, sometimes you will seem paralyzed. We seem like we have amnesia. We seem not to understand. Oh, don't be afraid, because it happened to even our prophets. When hope was gone, when his first wife Hope left, he was there beside the bed. He was calling her. And she came back and said, oh, Billy, this is what you preached. Hallelujah. This is what you preach, Billy. 2 angels came, one on this side, one on the other side. They were leading me through the garden. And when you come out, they said, I must go back. Hallelujah. I must go back, because that was the voice of the prophet calling. Hallelujah. It was the anointed voice of God calling. And so she must come back and answer that call. Say, Billy, why did you call me back? Why did you call me back, Billy? This is what you preached. Hallelujah. It was glorious there, she said. It was beautiful, Billy. It was more beautiful than you can ever see. Oh, hallelujah. He said, let me go, Billy. Let me go. Oh, the cares of this world couldn't hold her back. Oh, she had a child. She said, Billy, go get married. And let somebody take care of the child. Take care of Billy Paul. You promise me, Billy. Promise me you're going to find somebody. Find some good lady. Hallelujah. What we make a mother to speak this way? What we make a mother to speak this way? She saw the land beyond the river. Hallelujah. And by faith you can see it afar. Hallelujah. And one glorious morning, when the battle is over, oh, the Lord Jesus said, I have a better wine. I have a better wine. I will drink no more here, but I'll drink with you on that day. Hallelujah. I am thirsty for that day, but I know Apostle Paul said, for me to live has to be Christ. For me to die has to be gain. And so when I live or die, it is unto Christ. Hallelujah. When you wake up every day, you better give God thanks for the time that you have on earth. Why not decide today and say to God, I am going to repent if I have offended you. And the prophet said, repent means to feel sorry. Hallelujah. Repent means feel sorry. Feel sorry for what you have done. If you have done that, with the Lord said, don't do. Repent. It means feel sorry. You say to the Lord, I am sorry. I know what I did was wrong. I accept my fault. And when you repent, then you come back to him. Hallelujah. He's a loving father. Hallelujah. Don't you love him? He makes all things beautiful in his time. You may not understand, but he does understand. In his time, he makes all things beautiful. Hallelujah. But this beauty you see on this earth cannot be compared to what it has in stock. Hallelujah. My prayer, I say, Lord, when it's all over for me in particular, may I find favor with thee, that I will meet you where you are. Hide not your face from me, O Lord. If anything can prevent me from seeing your face, may you help me this day to take care of it now. Settle it now. Hallelujah. Because there's no settlement there. You settle it now before then. Hallelujah. Have you settled all your cases with it? Hallelujah. Oh, young people here, don't say, I am too young. I have nothing to settle. Yes, you do. Hallelujah. We don't pass by age. It is in his time. Hallelujah. You can plan everything you want. It's there in his time. Hallelujah. Amen. When he said it's all over from here. I don't want you to go there that day happy that you did the right thing. Hallelujah. You ate the word of God. You listened to the word of God. You acted upon the word of God. You stand still. Hallelujah. And you will see the salvation of God. Hallelujah. Because Moses could do nothing no more but stand still and see the salvation of God. Moses began to weep and cry. God told him, stand still, hallelujah, and see my salvation. Then Moses talked to the people, stand still, hallelujah. And this day the Lord is saying, stand still and see my salvation, hallelujah. I will make something of your life, hallelujah. I will make you a jewel like you sang. Oh, the jewels of the Lord, precious jewels of the Lord. Hallelujah. Your life will be meaningful. We have a purpose. No matter how many days it is, it's not the longevity. It's not how long you live. It is how you live. Hallelujah. It is not how long you live. It is how you lived. The values you kept. Hallelujah. The hope in Christ you had. The life you affected. Hallelujah. Yeah. Every place you go, show that you are a Christian. Hallelujah. Let the world know that Christ is still alive in you. Hallelujah. Do you believe it? Amen. Do you love him? Amen. Hallelujah. Blessed be his holy name. Thank you, Jesus. We are going to sup. We are going to drink of this cup, but we know it's just a type. For the Lord has assured us there is one we are going to drink with him. And I'm just waiting. Hallelujah. Are you in expectation of that?
Amen.
Are you looking forward to that? Blessed be the name of the living God. Hallelujah. And I've got to make it quick now. I will praise him. I will praise him. I will praise him, praise the Lamb of sinners and give him glory, all ye people, for his blood have washed away his sin. When I saw the cleansing fire, you can be on your feet. Hallelujah. Open for. Oh, amen. I obey the Spirit. Oh, in. And it's that I will be good. Hallelujah. I will praise Him. I will praise Him. Praise the Lamb of sinners. Giving glory to Him.
Amen.
Espera.